Good morning, I'm Harley Schlanger from LaRouche Pack with your daily update for September 28th, 2020. Today we're going to take a look at some of the latest revelations, which are contained in an article by Barbara Boyd on the LaRouche Pack site under the title, Three Bombshells in the DOJ-FBI Investigation. Now, the reason this is important is that we're seeing a whole new wave of coup-type operations connected to the 2020 election. This includes news stories of so-called Russian hacking plans. This was reported in the New York Times last week. A new CIA report where they say they're moderately confident in the analysis. Well, moderately confident means they don't believe it. But they're putting it out there, leaked to the New York Times, to turn a new aspect against President Trump. We also saw it with H.L. McMaster, the former Trump administration official, basically saying that there is discussion about removing Trump. He didn't deny it. This is a very real possibility of military involvement with McMaster, Mattis, former Secretary of State Colin Powell, and others talking about the possibility that the military will have to intervene to remove Trump from office, which starts with the assumption that he's going to lose the election. Now, that was the same assumption that they went into the 2016 election with, and the American people didn't comply with what they wanted. Now, it's unclear what will happen in November 2020. Joe Biden is not making a very good case for himself, and he can't because he supported the wars in particular that President Trump ran to stop in 2016. But let's take a look at these latest revelations. And we'll start with what President Trump said at a rally in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, on the 26th of September. He called the attacks on him a whole big con job. And he cited the FBI internal messages from 2016 where they wrote things back and forth to each other, such as, we shouldn't be doing this. We need insurance in case their jobs were lost. Now, this is part of a continuing story that goes back to the Peter Strzok, Lisa Page text messages about needing an insurance policy to stop Trump. And it also includes the statement, there's no there from Strzok, meaning there was no evidence of any wrongdoing, which later was confirmed by the Mueller report, although that still is the talking point that Russia intervened and according to Adam Schiff and others, Trump colluded and that the Trump-Russia connection is still a big deal. Now, on the Flynn case, which was a perjury trap, we have, in the words of the counterintelligence director of the FBI, Bill Priestap himself, a memo saying, we need to get Flynn to lie. Is that our goal, to get Flynn to lie? What Trump said in this Harrisburg speech is they decided we want Flynn in order to get to Trump. And as a result, he said we had a 2.5 year whole disinformation deal. And then in the same speech, he identified why this was launched. He said, we must stop these endless wars. Keep the U.S. out of these endless, ridiculous, stupid foreign wars. Now, all that was launched against him, which is detailed in this latest article by Barbara Boyd, was done to stop the president from breaking with the post-Cold War order that was established especially under the Bushes, the Clintons, and Barack Obama. A Cold War order based on British geopolitics and the imposition of an anti-sovereign neoliberal globalism that was destroying the United States, both the wars and the economic policies, which continue and are continuing to threaten the very existence and survival of our nation, along with the surveillance state apparatus that was put in power, or put in place, I should say, after 9/11. Now, here's the latest that's come out. September 24th, there were new disclosures on the Flynn case. This is what was referred to by Trump. 40 pages of documents released by Flynn's attorney, Sidney Powell, which show that there was additional exculpatory evidence hidden from the defense going into the case. Now, this case, it was scheduled to be dropped by the U.S. Justice Department, but the judge in the case, Sullivan, refuses to drop it. There'll be a hearing this week. Will Michael Flynn finally get justice? Well, we'll see. If you expect justice from this Justice Department, don't hold your breath, because it hasn't happened yet. The second bombshell, the FBI agent on the Flynn case, William Barnett, made clear repeatedly that he was unhappy and uncomfortable with the way the FBI was pursuing it. He referred to the "get Trump" attitude of the FBI agents involved. Barnett is the one who was in charge of the Flynn case, who said there's no basis for going after Flynn. And this was finally on January 4th, the FBI decided, of 2017, the FBI decided to drop the case. The next day there was a meeting at the White House, which included people like Susan Rice, a number of the FBI officials, including Comey, and they decided to reinstate the Flynn case. Now, Barnett, in his reporting, said that not only was there no basis for this, but he threatened to go to the Inspector General and quit if they continued with this approach. And what happened is they then took him off the case. They wouldn't allow him to participate. He was shut out of further involvement. So the revelations from Barnett, the new 40 pages of documents from the Flynn case, all demonstrate the corruption of the Get Trump Task Force. Now, finally, there was a letter from Attorney General Barr on the Steele dossier, pointing out that the so-called primary source for the Steele dossier, Igor Danchenko, had been identified in 2009 by the FBI as a possible Russian intelligence agent. Danchenko was interviewed in January of 2017 because he was known at that point as Steele's primary source. He told the FBI that he made up the stories about Russia, that these were barroom gossip with former Russian citizens, but the FBI never disclosed this when they went before the FISA court with the Steele dossier, which had been paid for by the Clinton campaign to get four warrants to surveil the Trump team. Now, one other point about Danchenko, which is not unimportant, is that he was working with Fiona Hill, who was a top Russia expert, so-called. And Fiona Hill was one of the key witnesses against Trump, which led to the impeachment of Donald Trump around Ukraine. Now, the whole story about whether or not Danchenko is a Russian agent is really not the point, because some people are using this to continue to say that the Russians were involved in the setup of Trump. There's no evidence of that sort, just as there's no evidence that the Russians engaged in meddling to help Trump win the election. What's clear, though, is the corruption that started in late 2015, which included the whole Obama intelligence team, which included a whole group, a cell, you might say, from GCHQ, the British equivalent of the National Security Agency, and MI6, that there was a coordinated effort to destroy the Trump campaign and then to constrain him or get rid of him if he pursued his policy of breaking with the Bush-Obama strategic doctrine. Now, it becomes clear when you look at the fact that the Mueller team wiped their cell phones clean, which should actually be a felony offense. Now, we have another aspect of this. A Danish newspaper, I can't really pronounce the name of it, but they had interviews with Bill Binney and Thomas Drake, who were part of the NSA, and they were confirming that the National Security Agency had a data mining operation going out of Copenhagen. And Drake said the reason for this is that the NSA had become addicted to surveillance. It is never enough data for them. It's the Stasi again, referring to the infamous secret police of the East German government. Now, why is it so important to come back to the story of the coup? Well, you have a couple of things. First of all, the geopolitical networks that oppose Trump are currently on a tear to try to provoke a confrontation with Russia and or China, possibly even before the election. What's the reason for this? Well, part of it, by bringing out the Russia story again, is to prevent Trump from meeting with Vladimir Putin, the president of Russia. Were Putin and Trump to meet in a situation which was not affected by this whole Russiagate story, the likelihood is that they would come up with some ideas that would completely scuttle these endless wars, the support from the West for terrorism, and would go a long way towards shutting down this so-called deep state apparatus that exists throughout the transatlantic region. Secondly, the reason this is important to bring up is what we've been exposing about the danger of a military coup connected to the presidential election. It's clear the Democrats are going minimally for a constitutional crisis, which they could then use as an excuse to bring in the military to remove Donald Trump. Much of this is contained on the LaRouche Pack site. It's written on the LaRouche Pack site about the revelations from Colonel Richard Black. So I just refer you to that as well as the Boyd article. And then finally, they want to continue the massive data collection of the security state, the surveillance state, which was exposed by Edward Snowden, which is part of what we see from the WikiLeaks reports coming from Julian Assange. And this is why Snowden was forced to flee the United States. This is why Binney and Drake are whistleblowers, and this is why Assange is rotting and being psychologically destroyed in a prison in Britain, waiting extradition to the United States. His crime? Publishing documents that show the truth about the Bush administration war, counter-terror operation, which included torture and so on. So if you tell the truth, you can go to prison. But if you cover it up, so far you have a get-out-of-jail-free card. John Durham, Attorney General Barr, come forward with the evidence. It's time for this network to be shut down before we end up in a nuclear war with Russia or China. So that's my report for today. I'll see you again tomorrow.